My dear brothers in Iman, Alhamdulillah ala ni'amihi al-kathir al-lati la tu'ad wa la tuhsa. Walhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-khuluqi fi din al-Islam. Praise be to Allah for favors that can never be counted. Continuously we are receiving from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His mercy. And praise be to Allah for the beautiful character of our noble Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, that shows a Muslim must always behave himself or herself. For indeed, the sign of a Muslim is a good character. Through good behavior and the best way of interacting with others, through speaking the truth and being honest and showing mercy and respecting of everyone and everything. Allah, to begin the journey of the human being on this earth, He began with good behavior within the home, between the children and the parents. He made it compulsory for every one of us to believe in Him, to trust in Him, to depend upon Him, to turn only to Him and to seek from none but Him. And that is Tawheed. And the opposite of that is Shirk. And He says in the Quran, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Indeed, denying Allah's oneness, associating others with Him, is the gravest, the greatest of sin you can never achieve on this world. And He linked with His oneness in His worship the behavior of the children with their parents. And He says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه. And your Lord, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has ordained, has made a law that you should worship none but Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And according to Allah, you must always be kind to the parents. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. This weekend, across the world, according to the United Nations, children were encouraged to celebrate their fathers. Father's Day, as they call it. Before that, Mother's Day. But if we look to the reality of the world we live in, the family is broken. The family is broken. That which Allah has forbidden and warned we should not do has been done and being approved legally. Divorce is rife. Children are growing without nurturing in behaving according to the teaching of Allah by realizing a family and the importance of the parents. Having a Mother's Day and a Father's Day is fine, it's good, but not good enough. If the parents are not together, if the parents are not legally married, if the children are not born within that marriage, then we denied ourselves the mercy of Allah. We have put ourselves in a position to allow Allah to turn away from us. For it is indeed He who says, worship none beside me. And after that, remember, you are born in a family, respect that family and look up to your parents and be kind to them. In another verse, Allah says, "Anishkur li wa li walidayka." Allah is the Shakur. Allah is the one who will never deny favors for his servants if they show gratitude. If you do good, Allah will do good by you. وَمَا جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. However, if you do not show gratitude to Allah, you will not be able to show gratitude to your parents. And be grateful to me, Allah says, and to your parents. They have brought you onto this world. They have nurtured you and raised you and looked after you. And your duty is to be grateful to them. You must serve them. And gratitude is not to say to your mother and father, shukran or shukriya. No. It's to act, it's to do. As they did for you, you do for them. But if we look at the world that is broken today, and we look at the family that is destroyed, we see children are planning for their parents to be sent to an old people home. I wonder, how will the child feel when he was young or she's young if the parents put them in children's homes? Doesn't make sense. No parents will give their children to anyone, but they must remain with them so that they can receive the nurturing and the care they deserve. How can we be grateful to them if we suddenly want to get rid of them, want to send them away? There is no excuse. There is no excuse. You can make all the excuses in the world. Your parents deserve better. Your parents deserve to see you. In this pandemic and the lockdown, how many parents who are living in old people home for almost 1 year and a half or more, they could not even see their children? How many children could not be in touch with their parents? What kind of life is? How many of them died without even having their parents next to them? Or the parents dying and the children cannot even see them? What kind of life is that? And we Muslims, who are supposed to show an example of the good behavior within ourselves, within our families, by marriage, by respect of the law of marriage, by love to one another and nurturing ourselves to be the best of people. As Allah said in the Quran, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You are supposed to be the best of people brought to mankind. What example are we showing? Are we good in marriage? Our children are fornicating outside. Most of them in universities and colleges, without your knowledge or with your knowledge, are having girlfriends. Many of them are having children and you don't even know that. Many of them are telling you one story and they are doing something else. Many of those who are married are having relation with others outside the marriage without even the consent of Islam or being married properly. We are following them. We are going through the same problems that they went through, and the Muslims slowly are leaving the tradition of building a home, of having a husband and a wife, being the parents through the righteous way, of being married with the consent of the wife to the husband, with the mahram, the father, the relative, agreeing the marriage with the witnesses, standing there to say, we witness. This is a marriage. With the dowry being paid to consummate the marriage. With the walima being established to celebrate that marriage. But Muslims are moving away from that. And those who are going through it, Soon, the divorce is taking place. You don't realize how many young kids today, marrying today, divorce tomorrow. How many children are coming from homes where the parents are not together? Imam Muslim, rahmatullahi alayh, in Sahih, Hadith says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day came out and said three times, رغم أنفي رغم أنفي رغم أنفي. The companion turned to him and said to him, who is it, Ya Rasulullah? Literally, رغم أنفه, when you translate it into English, it means it is he who will be humiliated and disgraced and will become a loser in front of all the people in the day of judgment. And the Prophet was very upset. He will be a loser. He will be disgraced. He will be humiliated. The companion want to know, who is this one? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من أدرك والديه عند الكبر أو أحدهما ثم لم يدخل الجنة. The one who lives to see his parents, both of them growing old under his shade and home, or one of them, but then he does not go to paradise. لن يدخل الجنة. Therefore, this hadith relate to us that to be kind to your parents is a reason for you to enter Jannah. If you have a mother who's old, or a father who's old, or both of them are old, and you do not enter Jannah, that means you are not kind to your parents. You are not good to your parents. You are not listening to the teaching of the Quran, in which Allah says, "Anishkur li wa li walidayka." Be grateful to me and be grateful to your parents. You are not serving them. How can you not be grateful to your parents? Some children, they argue with their parents. Some children growing up today, they say to their parents, you don't know anything, ma'am. You don't understand that, because they know better. The question is not for the children. The question is for us, the parents. Where did we go wrong? What's happening to us? Why are we having our children behaving like this? The answer is in the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Imam Ahmad radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in his musnad, also reported that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من أدرك والديه أو أحدهما ثم لم يغفر له أبعده الله. The one who lives to see his parents, both of them, growing old in front of him, or one of them, and he is not being forgiven by Allah, they will never enter Jannah, because they are not grateful enough to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, my brothers, being kind to your parents is the law. Being kind to your parents is the most important thing that is missing today in the life of the human beings. The United Nations, they bring statistics every year, and they tell us how many children are growing up running the streets, no parents for them. How many children are in homes, no parents to adhere to them. How many children are growing in single homes, where either living with the father or living with the mother. That is not a home. A home is where two parents create love, respect, mercy, understanding that their oneness within their home is an indication of the oneness of Allah. Their gratitude to their parents within that home is gratitude to Allah. Their kindness, their mercy, their generosity, their loving to one another in that home is a sign of reflection of the mercy that is Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The one who says, خيركم خيرهم لأهلي. خيركم خيركم لأهلي. The best of you is the one who is best to his parents, best to his family, best to his wife, best to his children. خيركم خيركم لأهلي. We need to ask ourselves, where do we stand in that? I said, the Prophet ﷺ said, in the Sunnah, explaining this, it's frightening. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says this, please listen to me, please listen. Don't say I am good, I am doing everything, but my children are going wrong, I don't know what to do. You must look into yourself, something is wrong with you. Wallahi. Because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never speaks but the truth. Never says anything by his tongue, but it is wisdom from Allah. Hikmah. He says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, birru aba'akum tabirrukum abna'akum. Be kind to your parents, then your children will be kind to you. When your children are not kind to you, look at your relationship with your parents. See how good are you to your parents. When your child is not listening, when your child is wicked to you, when your child is deceiving you, when your child is lying to you, look at your relationship with your father, with your mother. Look how did you, even if they are dead, remember, what did you do? Because sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if you are kind to your parents, your children for sure will be kind to you. They will be good to you. But if you are not, they are not going to be. وَعِفُّوا تَعِفُّ نِسَاءَكُمْ. This is where I'm really worried and frightened. When I see young Muslim boys and girls in colleges and universities fornicating and living a life of sin, I get very frightened. Because the future is no good. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَا تَغْرَبُوا الزِّنَا إِنَّهُ سَاءَ فَاحِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. لَا تَغْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. All the wrong of the family come from that. لَا تَغْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Do not come approach it. Do not look into it. It's the worst sin you can commit in the nature of the human being. And the worst path that you can take while you are traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah forgive us. May Allah forgive us. Look at our children. See what they are doing. عِفُّوا تَعِفُّ نِسَاءَكُمْ. If you are not maintaining yourself and holding on to your desires, no touching, no fornicating with other women who are not right to you, then your daughters, your wives, your sisters, your granddaughters will be clean. But if you do not do that, they will be touched. You touch a woman, Allah will test you in your family. That is the reality. Not my words. This is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. عِفُّوا تَعِفُّ نِسَاءَكُمْ. If you see your children going wrong, doing the haram, don't blame them. Blame yourself. Our parents taught us that. Our grandparents taught our parents that. So when you look at the children in the family, they are doing the haram in that sense when it comes to relationship between men and women, then check yourself. When you see something wrong with your children treating you, then check your relationship with your parents, your behavior with your parents. Don't blame the children, blame yourself. As Iblis will say in the Day of Judgment, when we blame him, he misguided us, he misled us. Oh Allah, he was the shaitan, he was the devil. Iblis will say, do you know me? We will say, no, we haven't seen you. Then he will say, la talumuni, do not blame me. وَلَكِنْ لُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. However, blame yourself. When you see your relationship with your parents as good, but your relationship with your children is bad, don't blame the children, blame yourself. When you see your children doing haram when it comes to relationship with women or boys and girls, don't blame them, blame yourself. What are you doing? What have you done? What should you do to correct it? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثلاثة لا ينظر الله إليهم يوم القيامة. Three people Allah will never look at them in the Day of Judgment. And tell me, What's the benefit of standing in the day of judgment, where the most important thing is to see Allah, and Allah does not want to look at you? What kind of life is that? It doesn't mean anything. Even going to heaven without looking at Allah is meaningless. As Rabi' al-Adawiyya said, I love you, O Allah. I love you for what you have provided for me, but I love you for you. I'm not frightened from your punishment in hell because it is you who can punish me or forgive me. I'm not really rejoicing to enter paradise without being able to see your face. For you are my paradise. This is a woman who lived in Mecca. This is a woman who walked the mountain. This is a woman who worships Allah by praying every day 1,000 raga'ah, frightened that she will not be able to see Allah. And today we just pray our prayer, sometimes even we don't remember it. Sometimes we don't know what we read in it. Sometimes we mix it together and join it. Sometimes we neglect it. Sometimes we don't even wake up to pray Fajr and we make excuses. And then we think we are going to Jannah. No. We need to be careful. Three, Allah will not look at them on the day of judgment. Number one, al-aqli walidayh. The one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, be kind to your parents, but he is wicked to his parents. He's unkind to his parents. He's not serving his parents because he's busy. He doesn't have time. Astaghfirullah al-azim. Astaghfirullah al-azim. وَمُدْمُنُ الْخَمْرُ at the drunken, the one who drink alcohol and he think it is fine. Allah will not look at your face in the day of judgment. وَالْمَنَّانُ بِعَطِيَّتِهِ and the one who gives, but he shows off what he's giving. He talk to people, look at him. He think he's, I'm providing for him. Astaghfirullah al-azim. You can't give people and then talk about it and be proud of it and ridicule others who receive from you. Allah will not look at you. وَثَلَاثَ لَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ and three, they will never enter paradise without Allah's mercy. الْعَاقُ لِوَالِدَيْهِ the one who is disrespectful to his parents. وَالْدَيُّوثِ the one who see his family fornicating, doing things that are forbidden without marriage, and he doesn't mind. And subhanallah, the culture we live in their culture, they don't mind if their daughters go with other men. The boy will ring the door or ring the bell. I want to take her on out. Some Muslims agree with that today. How can you allow your daughter to go with a stranger? You are responsible for her. You are her mahram. You will be in the day of judgment standing before Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he will be questioning you. We have given her to you as an amana. Why do you leave her to be abused, to be misused? Many girls, they are promised marriage by men because men are irresponsible. They are taking them out. They are doing every haram with them. When it comes to the marriage, we are not suited to one another. Girls are sitting crying. Look after your daughters. Look after your daughters. I know. Because thousands of them, they come to me, they ring me, they talk to me, they are crying. I don't blame them, I blame the parents. Because they are responsible for them. So at the youth, is the one who does not mind his children, his wife, his sisters, go out and fornicate. The youth, in the sight of God, he's not a man. والرجلّة, the man or the woman who tried to look like the other, the man who want to be like a woman or the woman who want to be like a man. Allah doesn't like that. You are a man, you are a man. You are a woman, you are a woman. And today, astaghfirullah al-azim, we are told you shouldn't say male and female. You shouldn't call him a boy or a girl, a man or a woman. Let them grow up and choose what they want to be. Astaghfirullah. And many of you sitting here, you hear it, you know, and you are agreeing with it without you knowing or not. I am not agreeing with it. A man is a man and a woman is a woman. And marriage can only take place between man and woman. Allah is my witness. if we stop believing in this, trusting in Allah and the teaching of Rasulullah sallam, then we are lost and we are no good. No good to be an example for people. Allah will bring down from the heaven Isa alayhi salam, and he will deny them. And then he will deny us. Because he will say, I gave the news, وَوَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِ مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَدٍ. I gave the good tidings, a messenger will come after me, his name will be Ahmad. What did you do with the teaching of Ahmad? What did you do with the example of Ahmad alayhi salatu wasalam? You didn't follow him, you followed the people who were going wrong after me. They made every law their own. They ridiculed the religion. One of the last thing I will say about this, one of the signs of disrespect to the parents is insulting your parents or swearing at them. The companion, Ridwanullahi alayhim, they hear the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, min kabair, aw min al-kabair shatma ar-rajul walidayh. One of the great sins, the big sins, the insulting of the child to his parents, ridiculing them or calling them a name. The companion says, قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَهَلْ يَشْتِمَ الرَّجُلُ وَالِدَيْهِ. How can a parent be insulted by his children? Or how can a child insult his parents? قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. نَعَمْ, it happens. يَسُبُّ الرَّجُلْ أَبَى الرَّجُلْ. You insult the father or the mother of somebody else, and in turn they turn and insult your father and mother. I taught in school for almost 20 years or more. Children come to me and say, Sheikh, he cussed my mother. A little child. That means he insulted my mother. What did you do? I cussed his mother too. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. So the one who began allowed the second one to do the same thing to his mother and father. Don't insult the parents of others. So they will turn and insult your parents. Because you began, you will be responsible. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, give us the tawfiq to understand and appreciate we have chosen to come and live in this land. It's not a land of Islam. It's a land of Christianity. Some of them are practicing, some of them are not. Some of them are believing, some of them are not. Some of them are good, some of them are not. We are supposed to live Islam by bringing our families according to the teaching of the Quran and the Sunnah. And the most vital, most important in that is to show respect to our parents so that our children will show respect to us. Is to raise our daughters and boys not about to fornicate. They should only have relationship in marriage. For if they do that, our families will be destroyed. May Allah forgive me and forgive you and give us tawfiq. Jazakumullah khairan. Shukran.